Pemain-pemain tadi nantangin kita loh supaya saya yang jaga Kaleb. Silakan jaga Kaleb.
To be honest, this was probably the first time that I never saw you to like totally trust the pass in this team.
Yo, what's up, school fans, and welcome back to the vlog. And it is a big day at the Oasis Plus All Indonesian. Hari ini big game antara Prawira Harum Bandung melawan Rancaba Bogor. Of course, penasaran kita akan lihat David Nuban and Fabio melawan mantan timnya serta juga Fernando Manangsang. Dan setelah itu ada Dewa United melawan Borneo Hornbills juga, guys. Itu juga untuk menentukan siapa yang akan lolos dari grupnya mereka. So, it's gonna be a fun day. I cannot wait, guys. Super excited for today. So, guys, pastikan kalian tekan like dan juga pastikan kalian juga komen di bawah. And thank you guys for watching and enjoy the vlog, guys.
Sepatunya Yuda. A-nya custom atau apa nih? Gila, mix and match. Sepatu Yuda hari ini. Ini kira-kira lagi pada curhat apa nih? Ini berdua udah 5 menitan nih ngobrol bareng. Seru banget kayak sih obrolannya. Nah, ini nih big day. Big day untuk David Nuban hari ini lawan mantan timnya. Kira-kira bisa nge-score berapa poin di hari ini lawan mantan tim.
Yeah.
Hati aja, walaupun kita nembak kalah, kita free bond kalah di statistik, tapi kita nggak peduli semua itu, kayak kita miss shot atau miss layup, balik, yang penting defense dulu, yang penting dari defense, offense-nya kita ngikutin. Jadi ketika kita ada satu orang yang miss layup atau gagal apa, kita bilang next shot, next shot, next shot. Jadi pokoknya defense dulu dan main pakai hati aja sih, itu sih.
Thank you. Dari teman-teman ini, silakan kalau ada.
Tur, ini rasanya kayak rivalry gitu nggak sih antara Prawira sama Rans?
Kalau gue kok dari tahun pertama sih kayaknya. Kayaknya kejadian tahun pertama itu yang bikin kita kayak jadi rival. Jadi kita setiap lawan Prawira nih, maksudnya mungkin gue sama Janu kali ya, yang kita kan hometown kita di sana, jadi kayak punya apa ya ambisi tersendiri gitu, terus mungkin ulang ke yang lain, jadi ya semangatnya mungkin lebih ya kalau mungkin.
Januar defense-nya jaga Yuda oke okay banget loh, gimana komentarnya? Dari coach boleh, dari pemain boleh?
Iya. Januar oke okay lah, dia mati juga ya. Dia first half si Yuda cuma 4 poin kalau gak salah. Ya dia, yang second half dia kecolongan, dia under terus. Ya udah dia akan 3 poin terus kan. Kita coba, jangan under, kita akan over terus, tekan terus dia. Dia cuma, dia doang kan, yang ngabisin poinnya. Kita kejar terus sampai dia capek. Akhirnya berapa kali dia nembak 3 poin? Gak ada masuk terakhir itu. Itu sih. Aiman kan dari Mane rugi dia gak pernah main kan. Cuma dari kita coaching staff setuju buat posisi 4 yang paling bagusnya di sini. Nah, kita pilih Aiman, soalnya dia punya size, punya agility, dia lari cepat, dia blok dari berapa kali. Ya kita kasih kepercayaan mereka ke Aiman gitu kan. Ya hasilnya, dia nunjukin situ gitu loh. Ya di latihan juga gitu, kita sering coba itu Aiman, main terus ya. Akhirnya dia pede akhirnya. Itu sih. Ya, kalau untuk yang kayak yang lain-lainnya mungkin kita akan rotate. Tadi game plan-nya sih buat di wing ya, cuma Fatur, Altov, Daniel kita rotate itu kan. Soalnya dia cepat, dia muda, dia punya speed-nya, dia punya defense-nya kan. Gitu. Makanya kita tadi ya udah mereka aja. Akhirnya berhasil gitu. Itu aja. Gitu sih.
Thank you coach.
Coach, cara ingetin Argus biar enggak boros foul gimana coach?
Wah itu susah sih. Cuma ya Argus sih Argus kan ya. Dia dengan ya kadang-kadang kalau dia capek ya emang ngeblank ya. Aku juga kalau pas main juga kalau kita lagi capek ya emang ya mau gimana lagi foul. Cuma ya pintu-pintu lagi dari coaching staff. Oh ya Argus berapa? 2, 3. Nah, kita tarik dulu ya, kita masukin lagi ya kayak gitu. Dari setelah lagi masuk lagi. Jadi dia tetap fokus jadi dia mainnya. Itu aja sih.
Okay, thank you coach.
Yes, I do. Today was a hard-fought win for Rance. All credit and respect to their team. They played very physical. They played very tough. They played very energetic. They took the game to us. We didn't take the game to them. And that's what we expect. That was the game plan to expect that. We didn't expect it. I don't know how or why, but I guess that's for me to find out later and somehow watch video and see what happened, but have some conversations. But the reality is they just played the tougher game. They made it kind of an ugly, dirty game, and it worked out in their favor. Not only that, we weren't able to score or shoot the ball well at all. You know, obviously the guy who's our best player, national team, star, you'd have probably had his worst game, maybe ever that I've seen him play here in a while. So I think it's a combination of that, with as well as like people just not helping or stepping up, and that's for me to help these players find solutions to score and create opportunities. I believe we missed double-digit layups tonight, front rims, off the rim, bouncing in and out. I thought we made every wrong decision. We drove the ball, we shot it when two people were guarding us, and then when we were open, we passed it. And that's also some player and some coaching as well to continue to help. No excuses. I think a week and a half, whatever, 2 weeks of preparation is difficult. I think every team probably had to deal with that. These guys dealt with it better with their style. We're a very systematical team. We're a very chemistry-oriented team, and we're adding new players and losing players and things like that. So I think just the chemistry of all of that is not there as well. And I even think that showed up in game one as well. So credit to Rands. I think this is a disappointing loss, but I'm not surprised. So yeah.
Untuk Pandu ada komentar hari ini?
Mungkin ya langsung disiap aja sih. Soalnya sebelum game juga coach udah bilang game plan-nya udah ketahuan, maksudnya bakal physical game-nya juga, terus mereka bakal push sama kita terus gitu. Ya waktu game yang mulai kita kayaknya udah kok nggak expect gitu, padahal udah diomongin gitu.
Dari
teman-teman
media silakan
mau
bertanya.
Coach,
yes.
Talk about Yuga.
Yeah.
You think he pushed too hard or was it part of the plan? I mean, 23.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah, I think for sure. I think he was rushing everything tonight. And I think to be honest, this was probably the first time that I never saw you to like totally trust the pass and this team. There was just so many things that are playing back in my head where it's just a guy that wide open. It's just like, he normally just passes it to him. He's wide open. Or three people close out, he's 5'7", you know, and there's 6'6" guys jumping and he's shooting it and not just passing it. You know, it's just like a simple thing. So that's just, you know, again, I trust Yuta more than any player in this league, or maybe Pandu right there with him. I'll go to war for Yuta any day of the week. You know, he's given me so much success in my life and my career, so this is, I said, a rare game for him. But it was really hard because I think he was seeing that we were struggling offensively, and he was just trying to be like, all right, man, well, I don't see that, I don't feel anybody else is scoring, maybe outside of him. And I think he just tried to take it, the whole team on his back. And I think that was probably not the right thing to do. But, you know, again, he saw the game that way. We have to live with the results. I'm sure he's feeling upset right now and probably disappointed in himself to play like that. I think, obviously, if he has a little bit better game, we easily win. He makes a couple better reads, we easily win. And then, like I said, I mean, not just him. I think overall, like, the amount of layups that we were missing just right at the rim was just, I haven't seen it in a long time, you know? I just haven't seen that many missed. So it's a combination of all of that. I think we need to get a little bit more creative with what we're doing here and figure out how we can continue to help the scoring and creativity of players being able to score and not just you having to shoot all the time. So that's gonna be the challenge for the next few months or whatever. Obviously we have one more game, but when we get into the IBL and things like that, I think that'll be my homework, so, yeah.
So, we just got done with the press conference dari game pertama, dan sekarang kita baru masuk ke game yang kedua. Gua telat sih, jadi udah mau selesai quarter 1. So, sekarang ini kita akan langsung nonton game yang seru juga antara Borneo lawan Dewa. Rookie make his debut. Ryan Leonard. Jaganya Caleb lanjir langsung. Jaganya langsung Caleb. Wow, ruginya masuk langsung ngepoin. Wah, Daniel Wenas dapat EI yang hijau ya. Keren banget ini. Matching lah sama jersey-nya ya.
Yeah.
koleksi sepatu ini ya. Gue lupa mulu namanya Nike apa ini, tapi regular season juga sepatunya ini terus. Eh, beda warna.
Saya apresiasi anak-anak di hari ini, mereka bermain lebih dari yang kita scrimmage sebelumnya lawan Rans, lawan Satria Muda. Terus mereka enjoy main basket di first half, tapi yang di second half kita mereka skor 51 poin. Itu yang jadi masalah kita di game tadi.
Untuk player, ada komentar untuk permainan hari ini?
Ya, kalau di saya sih kita kurang konsisten di second half aja sih. Oh, defense maupun offense. Mungkin harus next ya, konsistennya sih sampai selesai.
Ini kalau dilihat menitnya pemain-pemainnya banyak yang rata ya, nggak sampai ada yang lebih dari 30 menit kelihatannya. Ini memang hari ini mau lebih banyak rotasi atau gimana, coach?
Iya. Seperti yang saya harapin sih, kita tuh cuma 11 pemain ya, tambah ada pemain binaan satu dari Brian Leonard. Saya harap di turnamen ini sih kita, saya manajemen juga minta kami untuk kalau bisa semuanya bermain dengan minute play yang cukup rata, gitu aja sih.
Brian Leonard tadi masuk, emang coach udah siapin dia untuk main di game hari ini atau gimana? Boleh ceritain, coach?
Gini, dia datang waktu kita mulai latihan latihan. Dia udah datang Agustus, dia udah datang. Habis itu dia pulang ke Cina untuk kuliah. Habis itu saya harapin dia 2 minggu sebelum kita main ini dia udah balik ke sini untuk dia bisa ikut latihan, dan dia dapat satu kali scrimmage lawan Satria Muda kalau enggak salah. ya saya harapin sih dia pemain masa depan kita ya, tapi kita kan nggak tahu ke depan itu kayak gimana gitu loh. Saya rasa dia pemain ini kalau nggak salah itu DBL All Star 2 kali. Plus dia punya kapasitasnya sih dia untuk main di liga di IBL menurut saya sih.
Coach, jadi kalau lihat apa yang drop banget di babak kedua sampai bisa di outscore 51-31?
Defense itu yang drop banget. Ya mungkin kondisi mereka juga drop. Mungkin saya juga enggak. Saya tanya di lapangan sih mereka bilang enggak. Cuman apa yang mereka lakuin, pergerakan mereka secara kasat mata kita nih, kita ngelihat sih ya memang kita ketinggalan gitu loh sama dia di second half.
Kalau dari coach sendiri lihat kenapa sih Caleb itu susah banget kayaknya dijaga? Pak udah ketemu sama Caleb beberapa kali kan?
Gini, pemain-pemain tadi nantangin kita loh supaya saya yang jaga Caleb. Silakan jaga Caleb, silakan. Itu yang saya kasih. Tapi ternyata Caleb is Caleb. We can do nothing about that. Waktunya masih panjang untuk sampai ke sana menurut saya, ya kan? Dan menurut saya kalau ini menurut saya ya, kalau ini dimundurin nanti bulan Oktober akhir, November awal mungkin ya, kita bisa melihat hal yang seperti itu ya buat lokal pemain sambil kita nunggu pemain asingnya datang. Tapi kalau untuk waktu yang sedekat ini kita jalanin semaksimal mungkin yang kita bisa lakuin, ya kan? Untuk main di liga lokal dan liga ada asing plus naturalisasi itu beda banget. Nah,
terus ketika bukan berarti memandang sebelah mata tuh,
bukan.
Jadi ada nggak bagaimana coach Mel mengatakan ke pemain gitu, lu harus nyiapin ini ya, kita nanti berdua
pasti
ngebaginya sama yang kemudian lokal sama lokal itu kayak kebagi dua betul-betul gitu. Ada pemain-pemain yang katakanlah di saat ini dia big man, nanti barangkali di depan agak sulit berfungsi gitu.
Betul.
Gimana coach Mel membagi kayak gitu?
Gini kan, role-role mereka yang dari sekarang saya terapin di latihan dan untuk kedepannya nanti itu kan yang bakalan kita lanjutin terus sebenarnya. Nggak ada perubahan sih sebenarnya. Mungkin kita bakalan tambah beberapa pemain lokal lagi dan yang pasti import yang sesuai dengan kebutuhan. Nggak berubah sih saya yang kita siapin sekarang sama yang di sana, tapi memang adanya impor terutama pasti akan membuat segala sesuatunya menurut saya, kita siapin yang ini membuat segala sesuatunya jadi lebih mudah menurut saya, lebih mudah untuk kita mengeksekusi apa yang kita mau secara konsep. Saya di sini saya ini bermainnya dengan konsep gitu. Saya nggak pakai play, saya mainnya dengan konsep.
Bedanya gimana konsep dan play?
Konsep itu kalau play itu kita harus dari poin A ke poin B ke poin C ke poin D, langsung kita harus ngapain dari situ, kita baca dari situ. Tapi kalau dengan konsep kita mainnya dengan rules. Mereka ada di mana, role mereka seperti apa, kayak gitu sih. Jadi kalau dilihat Wisnu tadi dia bisa ISO drive one-on-one, itu yang kita mau sih sebenarnya, iya kan? Dia bisa catch, dia bisa nembak 3 point, kayak gitu, itu yang kita mau sih.
Good evening. First of all, I want to congratulate Coach Ismail. It's very difficult to play against him, with foreigns, without foreigns, whatever it is, it's always very difficult to play against a team coached by Coach Ismail. And at the same time, our players showed a lot of heart, fighting spirit, and determination to turn around a game that was very difficult for us. We were in a hole for most of the game. We even were losing by 18 points in the third quarter. And as I told the guys, they showed a lot of heart to turn this thing around. Other teams, our guys, who have given up, they didn't. Of course, Caleb here, because he played an unbelievable game, but many of them did, and it was a game we won with their fighting spirit.
Thank you, Coach.
Bersyukurlah bisa comeback, bisa menang, sama tadi.
Kredit untuk Borneo yang selalu bisa bikin sulit gitu ya dari season ke season gitu. Terus ya mereka bikin apa yang kita udah siapkan jadi gagal gitu ya. Banyak sistem yang kita udah siapin terutama di defense gitu, ternyata mereka bermain dengan cara lain yang kita harus adjust ke gaya main mereka gitu. Itu sih yang menurut gua kredit untuk mereka. Terus ya bersyukur lah tadi bisa akhirnya bisa comeback gitu. Tadi akhir-akhir banyak yang pemain yang step up di defense, terutama ada Pace juga yang banyak bikin poin-poin penting untuk kita.
Lab, the game looks so easy for you. It's just like, you know, looks so easy when you go to the free throw line, you gotta shoot, and then pop, you're open. Menurut lo, itu lebih strategi dari Coach Pablo atau gimana sih bisa bikin lo open selalu?
Ya pasti ya dari sisi dari Coach Pablo. Terus ya, gue sih ngerasa ya gue game-nya memang seperti itu gitu ya. Gue baca lawannya di mana gitu ya. Terus kan tadi mereka banyak zone gitu ya, jadi gue banyak cari-cari space di mana yang kan zone itu zonal gitu, yang di zonalnya nggak ada orang gitu lah. Itu aja sih. Jadi yang pasti sistemnya Coach Pablo juga, dan ya gue baca sih gitu ya. Itu aja sih.
Coach, for you.
Did you say I'm a very bad coach?
No. He said because of your system, he's always open. Pace, he usually doesn't get a lot of minutes from you, but this time you put him in the fourth quarter. He made a couple of big shots. Can you just talk about his game tonight?
Well, Pace is from Papua. They have different energy. Pace is a guy who has, like I said, a lot of energy. He's a very good on the defensive end, plays very aggressive. And he's worked on his outside shot. He's a guy who works to try to improve, to try to get his chance. It's true that in the IBL with foreigners he doesn't get a lot of opportunities, and here in the all locals it's a different situation for him. And even though he comes from the bench, he makes a great contribution. Even last game against Cantua, which was a close game too. He played the full fourth quarter also because of his intensity and his aggressiveness. He brings an energy and athleticism to the game that is very important.
And talking about aggressiveness, Patrick hitting the boards really hard, offensive rebounds. Just how happy are you to see Patrick playing this way?
Patrick, you know, Patrick and Tirta are the two hardest working guys on the team. They work so hard. After practice, even in practice, Patrick had a double-double today, 12 and 12. He fought very hard. We decided to go small with him at the 5, Khaled at the 4, and Patrick is a fighter. Patrick is a guy who has a lot of heart, you know, as an undersized 4, even for IBL with 4 lanes. So I know that whatever he does on the court, whether he can score or not, he will play 100%. He will give all he has, and even though he was a little bit tired, in the end, I thought that he was going to be, he was going to fight, keep fighting until he died. He's a guy that he will give all he has until he cannot anymore. So that's something we need to acknowledge from him.
Okay, thank you so much, Coach. Kalian ketemu SM ya di sini?
Yeah.
Can you just talk about, you know, rematch again, SM? Nah, yeah, local only.
Coach Pablo udah bilang sih tadi di kita tuh dikasih Tuhan, dianugerahi Tuhan ada kesempatan untuk rematch lawan Satria Muda gitu. Jadi ya pakai ini sebagai kesempatan untuk ya battle gitulah. Jadi jangan kita kayak SM tuh salah satu barometer lah di bola basket di IBL gitu ya. Jadi kalau misalnya lawan mereka tuh ya kita harus excited. Itu sih ya pasti susah sih, apalagi ada manusia, bukan manusia sih, manusia planet Namek sih itu, Abraham Damar Grahita gitu ya. Hati-hati aja nanti.